When you don't like those people or objects in the background, you just remove them. Using a filter after the snap to make a regular photo look vintage is as easy as a mouse click. So is removing a light post that seems to be shooting out of someone's head by using Photoshop. But in the world of photojournalism, these alterations are the subject of intense debate. And using Photoshop can land you in hot water, like it did for The Economist when it removed people from this beach photo of President Obama. Or for an Orthodox Israeli newspaper when it cut out the female leaders in this photo.
People do that all the time on their Facebook page. That's fine. We're the professionals. We have to maintain standards and ethics. We have to make sure that these photos are an accurate representation.
Photographer Michael Camber has covered conflicts around the world for the New York Times. His latest project, though, is curating an exhibition at the Bronx Documentary Center called Altered Images, which explores news and documentary photos that have been manipulated.
The more we looked, the more we found, especially lately, especially in the digital age, it was actually hard to bring it down to these 40 photos.
The exhibit spans photojournalism history and includes examples of staging, directing subjects, like the boy in this image, or misleading captions, this man was not a sniper, and yes, photoshopping. John Kerry was never at this anti-Vietnam rally with Jane Fonda. One of the first cases of controversial digital photo manipulation occurred in 1982 with the Great Pyramids of Egypt.
National Geographic took a horizontal photo and wanted to put it on a vertical cover, and they moved the pyramids closer together. That was something that really got people's attention. Another really egregious example of manipulation is the Los Angeles Times photo from 2003, where a photographer took two photos. They were both quite dramatic. There was a British soldier in the photo, and there was an Iraqi civilian. In one photo, he liked the way the soldier looked, and in the other photo, he liked the way the civilian looked. So he decided to just combine the two photos in Photoshop. And it was actually printed all over the world.
When the inconsistencies were noticed, the photographer lost his job. Photo manipulation is as old as photography itself. Take this photo of President Lincoln. It's actually Lincoln's head on Senator John Calhoun's body. Or this portrait of General Ulysses S. Grant. It layers three separate images from different times and locations. Even before photography went digital, the media altered photos. In this famous image of the Kent State Massacre, the fence behind the grieving teenage girl was removed. In 1994, Time magazine ignited a firestorm for making football hero O.J. Simpson, then accused of murdering his wife, looked darker and blacker than he really was. Newsweek didn't. In 2006, the Reuters news agency yanked a photo of the Israeli-bombed Beirut skyline after it learned the photographer used Photoshop to clone and darken the smoke to make the damage look worse. 2 years ago, the Associated Press fired the photographer who edited out a video camera seen in the foreground of the image of this soldier.
Once we start removing things from photos, then pretty much everything is on the table for negotiation. We can't be negotiating this. We can't be negotiating what is inside the frame. It has to be what was actually there when you took the photo.
Still, in this year's coveted World Press Photo Contest, 20% of the finalists were disqualified for significant alterations to their photos.
You've got technology and a public that knows it's there, which creates all kinds of room for doubt.
Columbia Journalism School professor Bruce Shapiro says the stakes couldn't be higher for setting clear ethical guidelines.
Powerful images of current events, of controversies, of abuses, have been an important driver of social change, of public policy. If the public, if the news-consuming, image-consuming, picture-drenched public loses confidence in the ability of photographers to tell the truth in a fundamental way, then the game is up.